हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द नेक्स्ट वीडियो ऑफ योर चैप्टर नंबर 15 सिमिलैरिटी। इन दिस वीडियो विल बेसिकली डू वन ऑफ द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक फ्रॉम योर चैप्टर, दैट इज बेसिक प्रोपोर्शनैलिटी थ्योरम, पॉपुलरली नोन एज योर बीपीटी थ्योरम। व्हाट इज द स्टेटमेंट ऑफ योर बीपीटी थ्योरम? दैट ए लाइन ड्रॉइंग पैरेलल टू एनी वन साइड ऑफ अ ट्रायंगल divide the other two side proportionally. That means if we have a triangle ABC and if we draw any line parallel to any one side of this triangle, okay, if we draw line parallel to any one side of this triangle, then in that case the other two side of this triangle divide each other proportionally. That means if we have triangle ABC and in that case we have DE parallel to BC, we are talking about this triangle, we have triangle ABC and DE is parallel to BC, then according to Pythagoras theorem what we have result, other two sides, that is AB and AC, they will divide each other proportionally. That means AD upon DB, this is equal to AE upon EC here. AD upon DB and AE upon EC, this particular statement is known as your BPT theorem. Basic condition for this that one side must be parallel to other side and result will be that the other two sides of the triangle will be dividing each other proportionally. Okay, now if we talk about the proof of this theorem, how we can prove this, look at here. When we compare these two triangle, we have ABC triangle here and other triangle is ADE. Okay, proof given, we have triangle ABC and DE parallel to this, and what we have to prove, that we have to prove that AD upon DB, that is equal to AE upon EC here. So we are comparing two triangles in this particular figure here. We have in triangle ABC and triangle ADE here. Two triangles are there, one larger triangle ABC and ADE in term of similarity here. If we look at here, we have a common angle A in both the triangles here. So first condition is that angle A is equal to angle A. Angle A is equal to angle A, which is common here. Then what we have, this is this angle and this angle. Okay, two lines are parallel and this line cut at point B and D here. So we have angle B is equal to angle B is equal to angle D, which is corresponding angle. Similarly, again we have two parallel line and this is a transversal here. We have angle C is equal to angle E here. Angle C is equal to angle E here. Again we have corresponding angle. So according to the angle, three angles are equal. According to the angle property of similarity of triangle here, according to the angle property of similarity of triangle here, what we have, these two triangles are similar. These two triangles are similar. And we have triangle ABC is similar to triangle ADE. Two triangles are similar to each other. And if these two triangles are similar, then what we have, their corresponding sides are in proportion. So we are talking about the corresponding side on the basis of their angle. On the basis of angle. So angle A is equal to angle A, side opposite to angle here we have angle A is BC over DE. This is equal to, again, side opposite to angle B, that is equal to AC over angle D is AE. This is equal to, again we have side opposite to your angle E, C is AB upon side opposite to angle A is AD. Okay, so second condition of similarity of triangle we have that BC upon DE that is equal to AC upon AE that is equal to AB upon AD. Now, we will take these two part AB and AC. AB and AC because we have to prove that these two side dividing each other proportionally. Now, we have AC is equal to AE is equal to AB over AD. AC upon AE is equal to AB upon AD. Now look at here. What is AB here? AB can be written as AD plus DB. This complete AB is AD plus DB. So we are writing AB is equal to AD plus DB here. Then next, similarly AC is equal to AE plus EC here. AE plus EC here. Now substitute the value of AC and DB here. AC and AB here. We have AE plus EC upon AE. This is equal to AD plus DB over AD. Okay. So, this term can be written as 1 plus EC upon AE that is equal to 1 plus DB over AD. 1 get cancelled here. So, we have EC upon AD, EC upon AE, EC upon AE that is equal to DB over AD. DB over AE. Now, what we have to prove? We have to prove that AD over DB that is equal to AE upon EC. We have these term here, but these are inverted. So, taking the inverse of both the term here, when you take the inverse of the both term, then what we have? We'll have AD upon DB that is equal to AE upon EC. This is what we have to prove here. Okay, so according to the BPT theorem, if we have a triangle ABC and a line is parallel to any one side, then in that case, what we can write that? We can write the other two sides dividing each other proportionally. Okay, we'll take one more example, then we will understand here. Triangle PQR. And second condition is TS is parallel to QR here. In that case, directly you can write that. We have a condition that one side is parallel to another. A line is parallel to one side of a triangle. We have a line is parallel to one side of a triangle. In that case, what we can write directly as since this line is parallel, so other two sides will divide each other proportionally. So what we have, PS upon SR that is equal to PT upon TQ here. PT upon TQ here. This is according to your BPT theorem. This is according to your BPT. Okay, so we can have any line parallel to any side here. Okay, we can have a line parallel to any side. So in this way, we can directly mention that the other two sides of the triangle divide each other proportionally. Okay, now. Now let us begin with our exercise 15B, which is based on your BPT theorem, that is basic proportionality theorem. First question from your exercise here, that in the following figure D divides AB into the ratio 3:5. We have given in this figure that we have a triangle ABC and D divides the side AB in 3:5. So what is the ratio of your AD upon AD over DB here, that is 3:5. This point divide the line into 3:5 here. Okay, this line divide the line. So what is the length of total AB will be, length of total AB that will be equal to 8 here. 3 + 5, that is equal to 8. Okay, this is what you have to understand, that this is 3 part, this is 5 part, so total part will be 8 here. So AD upon DB, that is equal to 3:5 here. Now what we have here, we have DE is parallel to BC. Okay, already told you, if any line is parallel to if a line is parallel to any one side of a triangle, so first condition that we have, DE is parallel to BC here, so we can apply the BPT theorem. So according to the BPT theorem, since what does BPT theorem say, that AD ratio DB, this is equal to AE ratio EC here. AE ratio EC here. So what is AD ratio DB? AD ratio DB, that is equal to 3:5, that is equal to AE ratio EC here. Okay, few things we have to calculate in this question. We have to find AE ratio EC. So what is AE ratio EC? It will also 3:5. Similarly, if we have to find the AD ratio AB here, AB can be written as AD over, AB can be written as AD plus DB. So AD is 3 upon, what is AD? AD is 5, oh sorry, 3 plus 5, this is equal to 3 upon 8 here. Okay, similarly, we can find the other side as AE upon AC here. AE upon AC. So AC can be written as AE plus EC. So AE is 3 upon AE is 3 plus 5, that is equal to 3 upon 8. So what is the ratio of AE upon AC? That means this small side and complete AC side, that is equal to 3:8. Equal to 2.4, DE is equal to 2.4. In that case, find the length BC. Find BC here. Okay. What we have here? Here we have to prove that first we have similar triangle in this particular figure. So we'll compare triangle ABC and triangle ADE here. Okay, so first we have angle A is equal to angle A common, and angle B is equal to angle D, that is corresponding. In that, this angle is equal to this angle, corresponding angle. Similarly, angle C is equal to angle E here, again corresponding angle here. This particular angle is equal to angle. So on the basis of angle axiom, what we have? Triangle ABC is similar to triangle ADE. Okay, triangles are similar, so their sides will be in proportion. So sides are in proportion, that means we have BC upon DE, on this side we have AC upon AD, this is equal to, on this side we have AB upon AD, okay, and we have previously calculated that what is AD upon AB, that is equal to 3:8. What we want? AB upon AD will be equal to that is equal to 8:3. Similarly, AC upon AD, it will also be AC upon AE. Okay, AC upon AE. Sides are in proportion. We have one proportional side here. We have proportional side as 8:3. Okay, we have the ratio as 8:3, AB upon AD and AC upon AE here. Now, it is given that DE is equal to 2.4. So, take B here. Okay, now, here we have the value of BC upon DE is 2.4. This is equal to what is AC? AC is 8/3 here. 8/3. And what will be BC? BC will be equal to 8 multiplied by 2.4. This is equal to 3. 8 multiplied by 24 upon 10 into 3. And it will give you 8. And this is 64 upon 10, that is equal to 6.4. So what is BC? BC is your 6.4 here. Okay? BC is 6.4. Understand? Then we have one more part. If BC is equal to 4.8, find the length of D. If BC is equal to 4.8, find the length of DE here. In that case, we have to find the length of DE here. Okay. In a similar way, what we have? We have the same statement and common ratio as 8:3. Now, we'll change the value like this. In the second part, what we have, BC is equal to 4.8 and DE we have to find out. Now, again, triangles are similar and sides are in proportion. So, we are going to take it as BC upon DE. This is equal to AC upon AE here. So, what is BC now? BC is 4.8 upon what is DE? DE is we have to calculate and AC is 8 upon 3. AC upon AE, that is equal to 8 upon 3. Now, cross multiply, it will give you DE, that is equal to 4.8 multiplied by 3 upon 8. Now, cancel the term. That you can cancel, that is equal to 48 into 3 upon 8 multiplied by 10 here. So, it will give you 18 upon 10. So, what will be DE? DE will be equal to 1.8. DE will be equal to 1.8 centimeter. Okay, 1.8 centimeter. In case when we have BC is equal to 4.8. Okay, so in this way you can find the different value given in the figure here. Okay, now next question from your exercise. Question number two. What is given in the figure? It is given in the figure that PQ is parallel to AB here. Since PQ is parallel to AB, so we can apply the BPD theorem here. Okay, so according to the BPD theorem, what we have? CP upon PA, this will be equal to CQ upon QB here. This is because of your BPD theorem. Directly we can apply the BPD theorem because one side is parallel to another side. Then, what is given here also, we have CQ is equal to 4.8, CQ is equal to 4.8. Then we have QB is equal to 3.6, this QB is equal to 3.6 here. And then we have AB is 6.3. This complete AB is 6.3 here. Okay, what we have to find? We have to find CP upon PA. We have to find CP upon PA here. Now, you can see here, since we can apply the BPD theorem, so we have to find out CP upon PA. So, CQ upon QB. CP upon PA, this is equal to CQ upon QB. This is because of your BPT theorem here. So, substitute the value. What is CQ? This is equal to 4.8 and QB is equal to 3.6 here. Okay. Substitute the value here. It will give you 4.8 upon 3.6 here. So, cancel the point here, it will give you 48.36, 12 4s and 12 3s. So, what is CP upon PA? This is equal to 4:3 here. CP upon PA, this is equal to 4:3 here. Also, we have to find the value of PQ here. What we have to find? We have to find the value of PQ here. Now, to find the value of PQ, what we have to prove? That we again have to take the prove the similarity of triangle. Two triangles are there, that is CBA and another triangle CQP. Okay, we'll prove that these two triangles are similar, and then we will find the sides are in proportion, and after that we will find the value of PQ here. Now, comparing the triangle here, comparing the in triangle CBA and triangle CQP here. Two triangles are there. We are going to compare CBA and CPQ. Angle C is equal to angle C, common here. Okay, angle C is equal to angle C. This angle will be equal to this angle. Angle B is equal to angle Q, that is equal to corresponding angle. Then this angle will be equal to this angle, that is angle A is equal to angle B, again corresponding angle. So on the basis of angle criteria, we have triangle CBA is similar to triangle CQP. This is because of angle axiom or criteria here. So triangles are similar, that means their sides are in proportion. So what we have? AB upon PQ, this is equal to AC upon PC, this is equal to BC upon QC here. BC upon QC here. Okay, we have given the value of, we have AB is equal to 6.3, and what we have to find? PQ, that is what we have to find. Again, what we have? We have the value of QC. We have the value of QC. What is the value of BC? BC is, your BC is BQ plus QC here. Okay, this will give you 3.6 plus 4.8. So it will give you 8.4. BC will be equal to your 8.4 here. Now, again, we have AB upon PQ that is equal to BC upon QC here. Okay, substitute the values here or directly find the value of your PQ as PQ is equal to AB into QC upon BC here. Substitute the value. AB is 6.3 multiplied by what is QC? QC is 4.8 upon 8.4. What is BC? BC is 8.4 here. Okay. Then we have 63 into 48 upon 84 into 10. So 7, and here we have 4 here, 9 here. This will give you 9 fours are 36, that is equal to 3.6. So what is the value of PQ? PQ is equal to 3.6. Okay, PQ. Next we have question number 3 from your exercise. Again we have given that triangle ABC and PQ is parallel to BC. What is given here? We have given that AB is 9 cm. AB is equal to 9 cm. Then we have CA is 6 cm. CA that is equal to 6 centimeter. Then we have AQ is 4.2. Okay, this is 4.2 and this complete side is your 6. And then what we have here, we have this complete side is your 9 cm. What we have to find? We have to find the value of your AP. Find the length of AP here. Okay, so first thing we have that this line is parallel to this line. So we'll prove that triangles are similar. Okay, triangles are similar here in triangle ABC and triangle APQ here. So again we have angle A is equal to angle A and angle B is equal to angle P. Okay, this is common angle and this angle we have corresponding angle and again angle C is equal to angle Q. This is again corresponding angle. So we have triangle ABC is similar to triangle APQ. Okay. Triangles are similar, so their side will be in proportion. So what we have? BC over PQ, BC over PQ, that is equal to AC over AQ, that is equal to AB over AP here. AB upon AP here. Okay. Again, substitute the value. We have the value of AB here. Then we have AC or CA. And again we have value of AQ. Take these sides. Directly take these sides. What we will have? AC is your CA. 6 cm. 6 upon AQ is 4.2 is equal to AB is 9 over AP here. So AP will be equal to 9 into 42 over 6 into 10 here, and this will give you 7 63 upon 10, that is equal to 6. Then we have question number 7 from your exercise. Look at this figure. What is given in the figure? We have triangle. We have this figure and dimensions are given here. And we have to find the value of x and y in the given figure. Now, if you look at this figure, we have 7.5, 4.5 and 3 here and x is missing. So, when you compare these two triangles here, we are going to compare, this is CD here. Okay. Now, first we are going to compare in triangle ABC and triangle FE and C here. In triangle ABC and triangle FEC here. Now, look at here, angle C is equal to angle E here. These lines intersect each other at point, these particular. AF and BE intersect each other at point C. So, angle C is equal to angle C, which is vertically opposite. Then, these two lines are parallel. These parallel line, this angle will be equal to this. Angle ABC will be equal to angle FEC. FEC, that will be your alternate angle. These are alternate angles. Then similarly, we have this angle is equal to this angle. Okay, this angle is equal to this angle. So angle BAC will be equal to angle EFC. EFC again alternate. So by angle axiom, what we have, triangle ABC is similar to triangle FEC here. Since angles are similar, so their corresponding side will be in proportion. So write the corresponding side, side opposite to angle C, that is equal to AB over EF. This is equal to, then side opposite to your angle B, that is equal to AC upon side opposite to angle E, that is equal to CF. This is equal to side opposite to angle A, that is equal to BC over side opposite to angle F, that is equal to CE here. So taking these two part here, what we will have, AB over EF, this is equal to BC upon CE. What is AB? AB is 7.5 upon, what is EF? EF is 4.5, this is equal to, what is BC? BC is X upon, what is CE? CE is 3. So X will be equal to 75 into 3 upon 45. Okay, this will get cancelled and we have 15 here and 5. So what is x? X is equal to 5. X is equal to 5 here. Okay, we have find the value of x. X is equal to 5. Now, after doing this, what we have to find? We have to find the value, next value here. We have to find the value of y. Now we have to find the value of y. After doing this, we have to find the value of y. Now, to find the in triangle BF, E and triangle BDC here. Okay, we are going to compare this triangle. First, we have angle B is equal to angle B, which is common in both the triangle. Also, this angle BDC, angle BDC is equal to angle BFE here, which is corresponding angle. again we have angle BCD is equal to angle BEF here, which is again corresponding angle. Okay, which is again corresponding. This line is parallel to this line. So we have a line parallel to another line here, and we have to find the value of this y here. Now triangles are similar, so triangle BFE is similar to triangle BDC. Triangles are similar, so corresponding side will be in proportion. That means we have EF over CD. This is equal to EF upon CD, that is equal to BF over BD, that is equal to BE over BC here. BE upon BC. Okay, now we have to find the value of CD and EF. CD and EF, and we have BE is there, and also we have BC is there. So taking EF upon CD, that is equal to BE over BC here. EF upon CD, that is equal to BE upon BC here. Now in this triangle you can see that what is EF? EF is 4.5 upon what is CD? CD is y, that is value that we have to calculate. What is BE? BE complete is BC plus CE here, which is equal to 5 plus 3, that is equal to 8. So what is BE? This is equal to 8 upon BC is 5 here. So Y is equal to 4.5 into 5 upon 8. This is equal to 45 into 5 upon 10 into 8. 10 into 8. So find the value of this particular term. On finding this, you will have y will be equal to 2.81. On finding it, that's it from this exercise. Rest of the question you can try by your own. We'll soon meet with the next video of same chapter, that is relationship between the area of different triangles, okay, or similar triangles, area of your similar triangles. Keep watching, keep learning. Thank you so much.